So the theme for this week is rarely used figures. So I was kind of racking my brain trying to think of what figures are rarely used. And then I realized, you know, especially in the ACBA group, DCUC figures are even are not used very often. So when I was going through my DCUC collection, most of you, in case you aren't aware, I'm a DC head. So it was quite easy for me actually to find a rarely used figure. So here I thought I'll go for the Big Bang. I have Booster Gold, I have Atom, I have Elongated Man, I have Blue Beetle. So these guys are kind of a bit similar to Marvel Legends or Marvel characters. So, you know, like, for example, you have Atom, who is a bit like Hank Pym. And then you have Elongated Man, who is kind of the Mr. Fantastic, the stretchy character. And then here you have the time-traveling Booster Gold and his best friend, Blue Beetle. So, these guys aren't featured very much. They'll be what I consider, or what you call, great heroes or B heroes or whatever you want to call them. So yeah, I think I kind of like how this display came out, so yeah, check it out. Today I passed by Smeagol, this shop called Smeagol. So they had this reading light that's shaped like a lamp, so I chose one in green because, you know, all Spidey villains are green, mostly anyways. So yeah, so I just did this scene, so where Gwen Stacy is reading a Spider-Man comic, and she's kind of like in a dream, so it's quite surreal. So there's a Mini-Mates Spidey with a Spidey sense tingling, and then there's a Doc Ock tentacle and the Sandman arm reaching out towards Gwen, and then there's some smoke effect to simulate Mysterio. So this is kind of like a dream or a nightmare, as I would you know, kind of like in my vision. So yeah, just a very simple display inspired by this lamp. This lamp, the battery doesn't last very long, so it's kind of getting dim quite quickly. It was much brighter earlier, so in fact earlier, you know, when it was shining, you could actually see the Spidey comic quite clearly, but now it's losing its power, so it's not as bright as it was. So just something fun. It's not very expensive, but I don't think it's very durable, as durable as you know, this reading light. I can't really show it here, but I've shown it in other episodes before. That one is pretty much more durable than this one, but just something that I bought just to experiment with. Yep, today was a pretty boring day, knocked off from work, was kind of wandering around, and then I decided, yeah, I'm going to grab the Mini-Mates. So this is a kind of a stretchy version of Mr. Fantastic, so I'm going to do a display. I already got my concept. And then I got this balcony prop that came with the Chitauri, the Marvel Select Chitauri figure. I don't have any need for the Chitauri figure, so let me know if you want the figure, and we can strike out a deal. So anyways, I'm going to get grinding to do a display. So stay tuned, and then check out my display that I have in mind. Okay guys, I strongly believe this is my most epic display yet. So I took out the two-pack, the Reed Richards and Dr. Doom, as you can see here. So I have the Thing from an earlier Hal, and I just used the Iron Fist flame prop as a my Mini-Mates version of the Human Torch. And then I use a Christmas decoration, kind of this shiny ball, to depict Invisible Woman, and yeah, and then there's just a mixture of props that I have at home. So I think this is a pretty epic display in my opinion. So I don't know what you guys think. So the Minimates display pick came out pretty well. So you know, I'm not crazy about Minimates, but then they do have this fun factor. And you know, recently I haven't been really into the DCUCs. I mean the new ones or whatever they want to call it, like the DC Signature, DC Unlimited, Batman Unlimited. I'm not really crazy about the new wave of DC figures. So I guess whatever budget I had or I used to have for DCs are going to certain Minimates now. So Minimates can be pretty fun, you know, they have this fun factor. So certain ones like Doom, for example, with the removable cape, and then I think certain characters like, you know, the Spider-Man with the spider sense, and some of the clear characters with effects like for example the Iceman, these Minimates I would probably get because they're pretty unique. So for example, this thing is in his trench coat. Mr. Fantastic has his you know, different accessories. So I think these are the only Minimates that I would probably get. So I'm quite happy with this, how this picture came out. You know, Minimates can be quite difficult to pose, but some of them, as mentioned, are really quite fun to do displays with. So I will continue to selectively buy those figures. Anyways, doing another display now using my bedside table again. So I uploaded the pictures of the Fantastic Four Minimates display I did. So it came to my attention that some people didn't understand what the Christmas ball was for. So basically, I was depicting Invisible Woman with a force field. So that's what the ball serves, the purpose that the ball serves. So anyways, enough about that Minimates display. So what I've done here is kind of what I call the life of Wade Wilson, or life of Deadpool. So here I have him in three incarnations. So the original, the Red Pool, with his buddy Bullseye. So they were assassins previously. And then later on, Deadpool declaring himself as an X-Man. And then subsequently, he's a member of the X-Force. So here I just did a very simple display with him in all three suits. So yeah, that's about it. And then I have one more display coming up, so stay tuned. So I re-looked at this display, so I kind of tweaked some stuff because I felt the table was a bit plain, so I added some props. I angled the guys a bit more. So yeah, this is my B-side version, so I hope you guys like it before I dismantle it. So this is the second display I had in mind and I did tonight. So this was kind of inspired by the theme, rarely used figures. I mean the Union Jack figure, B-Hero, seldom used. So here I have him in a display with the London in the background. So this also, besides the theme, he was also inspired by Victor's upcoming trip to London. And I'm also kind of possibly planning a trip to London, so this is quite apt. So just a simple vanilla display with the usual, laptop monitor as a backdrop, and I think the pictures should come out pretty well. So check them out. Okay, I must have taken a million pictures of this display here. So here you see I have a bunch of Joker thugs. So it's kind of different from this version. So if I'm not mistaken, I believe these guys are actually the Joker with a clown mask. I can't be 100% sure because I just know it's different from this version. So this version here is the regular clown thug, and I believe this is the Joker in the a clown mask. Maybe someone can correct me. So what happens is that why I have four Joker in clown mask is because I did this Christmas exchange with BDO. So BDO is one of my oldest friends in the I got to know from the ACBA group. So he was one of the first people that I started talking to and am still in contact with. So I sent him two shield agents a few months ago as a gift, an early Xmas Christmas gift, and then he got me two thugs, and then I paid him some money because he was getting the figures from Amazon, I believe. So he helped me get two more clown thugs, and this thug here is actually from Hugo Arias. So here I have a total of five thugs. So I just have them in a display with a date shot. So this is a custom date shot by Billy Mahoney. So I'm just doing a kind of like a group thug display. So they're kind of like on a construction site. So very quickly about the figure. So the regular thug has a different mask, and he's kind of like in a cowboy collar, and then he has leather shoes, whereas the Joker in a clown disguise is has Adidas on, and with just a button-up shirt and with a different mask, of course. So I kind of dig the Joker version rather than the regular, but it helps to have some variety, I guess. And yeah, so just a simple display I put together, but I'm kind of trying to take as many pictures as possible to get the best angle and the best look and feel. So I'm still grinding. So check out the pictures after this short segment. So when the theme of unlikely teams came up, I immediately thought of Deadpool and Nick Fury. So in case you guys aren't aware, in the comics, the two of them hate each other's guts. So thus it kind of matches the theme. So I think to make it a bit more realistic, because Deadpool is crazy about money. He's a mercenary after all. So here I have my custom Fury made by Billy Mahoney. And Deadpool kind of doing a transaction. So in the sense it's unlikely, but yet at the same time possible because of money involved. So I have them kind of sealing the deal by helping each other. Fury helping Deadpool light up a cigarette. So the cigarette and the cigar is also made by Billy Mahoney. So a fantastic figure that I bought from him. Commissioned him, he completed the figure and then he sent it to me. So very dope figure, definitely my favorite custom figure that I own. So yeah, just not very complicated setup. Sometimes some of the newbies, the young bloods, they try co very complicated displays and fail spectacularly. So sometimes it's good to just do very subtle displays, and I think this I hope this hits the mark. rarely feature my Human Torch figure and Iceman. But I thought it was about time, you know, to kind of do a picture of them. So this was actually inspired from reading the Ultimates comics this afternoon. So I thought I'll quickly do a picture of the pair of them. And later I'm going to do a variant picture, so stay tuned for that. Recently, I've kind of been enjoying the Minimates figures. So here I made some webbing out of the Twisties. So I paired up Spidey with Daredevil, and I just have a cutout. So yeah, I don't know, you know, I used to not have this thing for Minimates, but recently, I don't know, I've kind of changed my mind. So I'm kind of in this Minimates phase at the moment, because there aren't many new legends coming out, and as mentioned, you know, DC UCs are, you know, kind of sucky at the moment. So yeah, I'm gonna do a variant picture, and I'll be right back. Yeah, so here is the B side on my variant. So I have Spidey piggybagging Deadpool. So just something for fun. Pretty dope. It's quite funny. I think that's kind of the reason why Deadpool is so popular, because you can do wacky stuff like this with him. And I guess Spidey and Deadpool are pretty much the two funniest, wackiest characters who like to crack jokes. So this is pretty apt. So I'm going to post both pictures on the ACBA group, so check it out. Here is an aerial view of my Minimates setup. So this is the first class Minimates set. So pretty dope. I bought it mainly because of Iceman and Angel. They have very nice details on them. And of course, it came as a set, so you can't have Iceman and Angel without Jean and Scott. So here I have the complete set, and I just threw together a bunch of stuff, and then put them into a display, which I thought was pretty dope. I hope the pictures come out well. So in the background, you can see Iceman kind of sliding down an ice slide. So this is from the Toy Biz X-Men Classics figure. So it's a prop that came with that figure. So I finally got a chance to use it with this in a display. So I used it with the Minimates Iceman. So I think it worked out pretty well. I'm quite happy with the results of the pictures. Okay, so this has been pending for a while. So I bought the Kotobukiya plastic kit model of Danbot. So here's the box, and then the inside of the packaging, which is quite cute, is actually the head of the Danbot. So I'll go ahead and open up the package and start to assemble the kit model. So I'll be showing some footage of the work in progress. So be patient while I cut out and assemble the kit model. So guess what, I'm making some pretty good progress. So I've completed the torso, and I've also completed the legs. So what's left is the arms and the head. So yeah, stay tuned. So there it is, I've completed the Kotobukiya kit model Danbot. So anyways, the finished product comes in three main pieces. The head, which goes onto the body, of course. But in case you guys aren't aware, if you read Yotsuba, there's actually an issue where Yotsuba visits Ina-chan, and at Ina-chan's house. Okay, I think I won't say too much, but basically Danbot
being a cardboard robot was capped. So this extra panel here goes into the bottom of the head to simulate the body being capped. So here you see the body. So the body is being capped within the head. So this is what you Danbot looks like. When it's kept in storage. So this piece doesn't fit very well. I think because it's meant to be detachable. So probably when I do a display, I have to use blue tack or tape to hold the piece in place to do a proper display with Yotsuba. So yeah, I'm definitely going to work on a display on that. So stay tuned. So I was doing some research on the Danbot character. So you know, the kit model came with a bunch of stickers. But so far, based on my research, there's only the "You did a great job" sticker that was stuck by the teacher on the project. So I think I'm only gonna put that particular sticker on the figure for authenticity's sake. So yeah, I'm gonna do that in a moment. Okay guys, so I finally got down to painting Danbot. So as you can see, I added silver detailing, and then for the switch, I painted it black. So I'm just kind of gonna leave the figures alone to dry. So I'm gonna do other displays and reviews instead. But I did take the opportunity to paint the claws, the retracted claws of Wolverine. So that's something dope that I managed to do with the paint pen. So yeah, I'm gonna just leave the stuff be for the moment and talk about other things. Okay, crazy package from my brother Rick Valdez. So here I have the SDCC exclusive Lobo. Very, very impressive figure. Definitely worth the money I paid for him. So he's complete. He comes with the 3D glasses, the hook. He comes with a space pistol, a rifle, and his pet dog. Very dope. And then Rick also sent me other stuff like the Atom Smasher figure. It's a CNC figure complete. He also sent me a block figure. This is my own. I actually got another block for Victor, which is a cat. I got another Red Pool. Who has enough Red Pools? So I have two Hasbro ones. I have my custom Red Pool somewhere. And then what else did Rick send me? Rick sent me a ghost figure. But okay, the only problem is that the foot broke off. So I probably have to ask for a big favor from Billy Mahoney to help me to fix that. And yeah, that's pretty much the how for, oh yes, sorry, before I forget, there's an arcade machine as well from my buddy Rick. So I'm just gonna do some displays and then stay tuned for more Mato. Well, the more I play with this figure, the more impressive it is. So here I just did a very simple setup with his pet. So I'm still trying out what's the best way to pose him, but for the moment I just do him vanilla. Actually, I kind of wanted to do him in the sitting position, but his belt is kind of in the way. So I think I have to kind of consult with people like Fernando Galagos, who owns this figure, about how best to pose him. But for the moment, I'm quite happy with this setup. So I just got back not too long ago, from meeting up with Mindless. So he actually helped me get 3 Kamen Riders, Shocker Combat Man. To be very honest, I know nuts about Kamen Riders. But you know, the last time while filming Mindlessly Awesome, I had a lot of fun with the Shocker Combat Man. So I decided to army build these guys. So what I have here is I have 3 of them. My ideal number is 4, so I'm going to try and get one more shocker. So in the meantime, I'm not sure if I'm going to do this review of this figure this very night. But I'm going to quickly do a DC picture first, and possibly do a Dan Bought one since the paint has dried up. So stay tuned. Yeah, I was supposed to release Mato last night, but YouTube was giving me fits. So anyway, since I wanted to do a quick picture, I thought I'll do this one. I had this idea kind of brewing in my head for a while, so I quickly took this display, and I'm going to insert it into Mato. So this is kind of bonus material because of YouTube's fault. So enjoy this display. So I decided to do a variant pick where Yotsuba switches sides. You know, previously I did the picture where Dan Bought whacked Yotsuba, so now I have Yotsuba whacking Dan Bought. So just something fun I like to do, other than you know seeing the usual Batman, Marvel Legends characters and so on and so forth. So I just thought I'd do something different. Yes, just something on the logistics side. YouTube has been giving me fits. The damn YouTube editor hasn't been working, so I have to figure out something so that I can get this video up. So yeah, I have to do some troubleshooting.
Crispy.